My name is Kande Yumkela. I am the Director General of the United Nations Industrial Development Organization, which is based in Vienna, Austria. I have just been appointed by the UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon to be the Special Representative for Sustainable Energy for All and CEO of the initiative. I'm in my village in Kichom, where Munir has been serving as a Peace Corps volunteer helping the school. What we did over the last year and a half, we've been distributing solar lanterns here to the families based on a model for lighting developed by Dr. R.K. Pachauri, the Nobel laureate from India, who is the head of TERI, the Energy and Resources Institute in India. Basically, the concept is that if you provide basic lighting to rural families, you can improve their welfare, particularly also improve the educational opportunities for children. And so in this small village, Kichom, with 250 households, I think we have roughly here between 3,000 to 4,000 inhabitants. It's a little island, very, very poor. In this community and some neighboring communities, we've distributed about 300 solar lanterns, which we brought in from Delhi. The concept combines microfinance and lighting in the following sense. We've built about 3 charging stations in the village where they have solar panels. Every morning, people take the lanterns back and they rent the lanterns. This allows for a couple of people to be sustained over time to do repairs and maintenance. So we've distributed about 300 of these, and it's making a difference here. And Munir and his colleagues have been using the extra 2-3 hours of lighting they have in the evening to see how they improve the academic potential of these kids. It's really a credit to them. They just saw the advantage. They wanted to help the kids. And in fact, he has his own story. It's better you hear from him. Secondly, this today, as I'm being recorded, we're doing another thing. We also got a technology from India, which is called a biomass gasification technology, to help the farmers, which this is mainly a farming community, use the waste from their rice processing as feedstock to generate energy, which, and here we're laying the cables today. The community is providing labor and the government has provided the technicians to put the transmission lines in place. This will provide 32 kilowatts for this village. It's not much, but since it's only for lighting initially, we hope we can light the school, the community center, and also the little medical center they have here, and some households. The future is what? Our vision is the following. We want to integrate various renewable energy technologies so that this can be a community that is fully self-sufficient in energy. We'll integrate solar, biomass gasification, and my hope is also methanization technology. I have seen this methanization where they use human and animal waste to generate methane, which can also be burnt to create power in the community. You integrate all three, biomass, solar, and methane, this can be a community self-sufficient with energy, which means you improve the agricultural life, you improve the life of women, and also maybe raise their income levels. But I'm just grateful that Munir and his mom have been here. I mean, it's amazing for me, people living in the United States, living in my village, even me staying here is not easy. You don't have clean water, they depend on well water, but it's really credit to them that they can leave the first world to help poor people like this. But for me, it's my reality. I'm leading a major international agency. I live in Vienna. It's been rated the best city to live in 4 years in a row by Mercer, the rating agency. Imagine. Coming, my office is on a 22-story skyscraper there. I live there to come here in this village. So I'm actually bridging two worlds, living in the best city in the world and living in one of the poorest locations here. But it's my reality. That's why I want to help people, and that's what I do in my life. Thank you very much for giving me this privilege. But again, thank you for coming to help my people.
Thank you, Dr. Kande. We really appreciate it.